Wow, an incredible hit.
Sebastian Loeb. Travis Pastrana, take it, check it.
And wow, what a season it's been already here in Las Vegas. Global Rallycross Championship. This is it, folks. The final bout of the season for the 2012 crown. And we've got some different rules for this round. Jen, take it through it.
We've already seen the first heat, so we're starting with round two. Two heats of seven cars. The top four in each heat will advance to the final. And the critical championship point is at grabs there for the winner of each heat. LCQ, one heat, six cars, and the top two advance to the final. And the final, 10 cars.
So last night, we had some heats which defined your start position here tonight. This is Tanner Faust in his heat, and I have to say, Jen, he really looked in command the whole way through.
Absolutely, that's the strategy. Get out front early and lead right to the end. You can see Thomas, Toby Häkkinen there, trying to chase Tanner Faust down in the long right-hand sweeping turn, but tough to do it when you've got the lead, and there's Tanner taking the checker.
So Tanner takes the checkered flag, but most importantly, he takes the bonus championship point for winning that heat. And then Brian Deegan comes up in heat number four. He jumps the start, and he gets shuffled to the back, and there he is getting stuck behind Samuel Hubinette, the orange Saab.
It is so tough to overtake on these courses anywhere other than on that shortcut. Samuel Hubinette really strong out front there as Saveri tries to take him in the first corner, and those two are going to be battling it out while Brian Deegan bides his time and waits until his very last lap to take the shortcut and see if maybe, just maybe, he can come out in front of Samuel Hubinette for the checker.
And coming through the last turn, Deegan puts the hammer down, and he does take the checkered flag, takes the championship point, and that keeps Tanner Faust and Brian Deegan even coming into tonight. Fantastic racing already here in Vegas. Now, let's take a look at the championship point story. There you see 73 to 67, only 6 points separating these two contenders. Right now, Alyssa Roenig is caught up with Tanner Faust. Alyssa.
Once again into turn one with the sun the way it is. It's going to be chaos descending on Las Vegas right now. I can't wait to see it.
All right, so guys, I talked to Brian right as he got into his car. He said he knew he couldn't afford a jump start today. He's chosen some more soothing music, a little Hank Williams Jr. before the start of this race.
Thanks very much, Alyssa. Let's take a look at the Global Rallycross Championship course here in Las Vegas. 30% dirt, 70% tarmac into the first turn into the Discount Tire, America's Tire, hairpin turn. At the exit of this turn, they have the option once per heat to take the shortcut. It's tight, it's technical, but it could be as much as 4 seconds faster than the long lap. On the long lap, you approach the jump. It's still 70 feet from the takeoff to the sweet spot, but it's all dirt this time. Once they get to the end of that, they got to be on the brakes fast and into this long right-hand turn. They can see the car on the shortcut here, so they're going to be trying to come out in front of whoever's on there in the course merge. And there they go, across the finish.
Well, let's take a look at the Discount Tire, America's Tire starting grid for tonight. There you see them lined up for round two, heat one. Ken Block, Brian Deegan in the front row for this one, next to Samuel Hubinette.
That's a really tough spot for Brian Deegan to be in. Ken Block qualified in the number one position. He's got the best position off the line. He's going to try and get into that first corner as the first car and lead wire to wire. We'll see what happens when they start.
Here we go. On the line. They are ready to go here in Vegas. And they're off for the first heat of the evening. Who's going to make it to the corner first?
A lot of crashing and banging and bumping. Those guys are blind into the sun at this time of day into that first corner. And Ken Block emerges first. And our new guy, Bryce Menzies, in second position.
What I noticed there is that we actually had a little bit of a pinch happening on Brian Deegan with Sverre Isaksson. So Brian Deegan right now is lagging behind, and that spells trouble for him.
And Brian, yeah, as these guys approach the jump, we're going to see Brian over the jump in just a second. He had a little bit of a bobble and hit a wall, too, so that's going to be very tough for him to recover from.
And remember, folks, it's important to try and win these heats because there is one bonus chance. championship point. Ready for grabs. Kent Block, though, looking great out in front.
Very good number one qualifier. His car is set up. It's very powerful, and it's working very well for him. He's also really comfortable on all of this dirt. He's been competing in the World Rally Championship, and he has no trouble with it at all. You can see the sun. We have Sverre Isaksen stopped on course. I didn't see what happened there, but maybe a mechanical problem. This sun is a real challenge. It's going to change as the heats continue, but it's a disadvantage right now, absolutely.
So the dust in the air, that's going to make quite a bit of a problem. I see Brian Deegan coming limping through there. You see Bryce Menzies just beaten on the back of Pat Morrow Subaru. And look at the glare of these guys, not just the dust in the air, but what's happening there? That's the onboard of Brian Deegan, and he stopped. He's out of the race. Oh, disaster for Deegan.
He was looking for that critical championship point that he could get by winning this heat, and there's no way he can do it now.
Oh, no, you saw his wife, Marisa Deegan, looking on. So he's not going to get the point, but most importantly, is he going to be ready for the last chance qualifier, which he's certainly going to end up in? Disaster for Deegan there. You see the fight between Bryce Menzies in the blue car and Samuel Hubinette in that orange star. This is great racing.
Very good battle. Bryce Menzies competed at X Games, but this is his second time in that Dodge Dart as we ride along over the jump. He's doing very well. He's taken some time on the course and made some improvements to his driving style. He's a dirt racer usually, just won the Pro 2 Championship for the Short Course Off-Road Championship. But look at him go, putting the heat on Samuel Hubinette.
And while these two battle, you can see Ken Block is actually extending his lead a little, so that's really helping Ken Block in this race.
Being out front and having a clear track to run on is a definite advantage. You want to lead right from the start and try and hold it to the end. Look at that sun, just blinding, especially when you get in on the dirt section here. They get dust, and you just can't see anything from
it
onboard.
It looks like Menzies is slightly faster in that Dodge Dart, perhaps, but he just can't find a way past the Saab Hubinette. You see the white flag, this is it. One lap left to go in this race.
And there's Brian Deegan limping along the course. That's good news for him. He was able to get his car started again, but it's very clear that there's something wrong. Oh, we'll have to see what happens.
I think Brian Deegan was trying to play it smart here because he realizes the number of cars that advanced, there are at least two cars out crippled on the course. He's just trying to hang on and maybe get a transfer spot and not go into the last chance qualifier, but I don't think it's going to be enough. Let's see what happens as they come to the checkered flag. Ken Block taking it above Samuel Hubinette. And there's Bryce Menzies. And I think it's going to be Mira taking that fourth spot. Well, there's the winner of our race. And there, unfortunately, is the leisurely drive across the line. He didn't want to take his wife, Marisa, incredibly disappointed. But Brian Deegan has to be crushed right now. He really needed that point. But again, it's not over till it's over. Tanner Faust still has to make sure he stays out of the last chance qualifier, Jen.
And what Brian's trying to do here is just knock off some of this lap. If he can do more laps than the two cars that stopped, he finishes ahead of them in this heat. So I almost wonder if it's maybe a transmission problem. He can't get out of first or second gear.
Well, I think this was really all down to the way this thing started. Brian Deegan had a space in the front, but somehow he got crushed.
He's a very good starter, but Ken Block's car is powerful. And there he goes. He gets pinched in between Sverre Isaksen and Samuel Hubinette. The three of them just ride around that corner all at once. And he ends up way back at the back. Tough to recover from that in these short heats.
And here we see Dave Mira coming into the shortcut, really going hard onto that dirt, and he spins this thing around. Wow, he's just pushing it a little bit too hard in the Subaru there. But the real story, heartbreak for Brian Deegan in this heat. He limps over the line. Will he get the Ford ready for that last chance qualifier? You see the results there. Block, Hubinette, Menzies, and Mira unofficially advancing through to the final, and Brian Deegan just in fifth place. He goes to the LCQ. Welcome back, Vegas, Nevada. The Global Rallycross Championship Finals from the SEMA show. Take a look at this track. A lot of dirt. It's different to a lot we've seen. And there is the Allsburg team working hard on that Ford of Brian Deegan. The disappointment for him in that last heat, taking fifth and not transferring through. And Alyssa has caught up with Deegan. Alyssa, what's he got to say?
Brian, I know that was a disappointing first heat. What happened?
Well, I had an okay start. Came out with Ken pretty even, and we went in that first turn. I thought it was good. I was just tucking in with him, and then I just got plowed from behind, and I just turned into a big pileup. Everyone just kept running into each other, and I know it was kind of like amateur hour going through the first turn, so nothing I could really do about it. Just got ran into, blew my tire off the wheel, so that's racing. That's how it goes sometimes, you know? So, you know, I guess just have to return the favor someday.
When you got in here, I saw you run over to your mechanics. Do you think you'll be able to get the car back out there for the LCQ?
Yeah, there's an LCQ, so we got to get the car ready and get it ready to get back out there. Can't give up, you know? Just got to keep going. Anything can happen, and it's going to be an aggressive race. It's just how it is. Sometimes you got to fight all the way through it, and so that's what we're going to do. We'll be back.
All right, we'll see you out there.
Well, that was a very mature Brian Deegan there, and I don't think he's going to give up at all. We know that team is just fantastic. They'll get the car ready. But take a look at this again, Jen, going into the sun.
They are absolutely blind. They can't see anything. Lots of bumping and banging. He did not get hit from the rear, but it's so chaotic, it's hard to tell what's going on. Got sandwiched in there. It's just crazy how they're fighting the sun.
But take a look at this sun. It's just incredible. You literally can see nothing. And as that dust started to build up, it got worse lap by lap. So now Brian just has to hang around and hope this amazing team of mechanics get the car ready and deliver him to the line for the last chance qualifier. But again, the most important thing for him is he lost the chance to get the extra point. Wow. So join the conversation with all the Rallycross fans right now on Twitter. Use hashtag ESPNGRC and experience racing on the social track. So there we go. Tanner Faust sitting on the line. Look at the starting grid for this race, though. And most importantly, who's next to Tanner Faust?
Timur Zanov. He is the ERC champion for 2012 in this grid of these seven cars. We have 9 of 10 European Rallycross Championship victories this season. Very competitive between Liam Doran, Tanner Faust, and Timur.
And all three of those racers are actually in this heat. So Timur Zanov, and we've definitely been practicing this name all week long. The Russian is ready to do battle. We saw him in the heats and we saw him in practice. And this guy looks incredibly fast in that best by Ford. Will he thwart Tanner on the extra point? And we're racing here in Las Vegas. Faust blisteringly fast into the first turn and another pinch.
Those two guys fastest off the line, but Stefan Verdi is trying to capitalize on it. Timur, look at that rallycross experience, defends his position and keeps Stefan Verdier out of his way. So the two of them are chasing each other down. Tanner Faust first through the shortcut while Timur goes for the longer lap.
So Faust, Doran, they go through the shortcut. There you see Timur Zanov, the Russian in that blue Best Buy Ford. He is going over the jump. So he still has the shortcut to take. We'll see if Faust was smart in getting out in front by doing the shortcut.
Timur was really excited about competing against Faust at this event in a virtually identical car. They've been in different cars this season in the European Rallycross Championship.
And that onboard there, you could see that Timur is pushing Verdier. He's trying to actually get past Verdier. And I think he actually knocked him off course. I wonder what the course officials will say about that.
It's that aggression. And you know, there's a very fine line between a black flag and something that's okay and is going to get you a little bit of position.
Liam Doran off the side of the course. So that's the end of the race for him. He will have to go through to the last chance qualifier. Looks like Verdier is off the course also after being pushed out by Timur Zanov. So remember, four will transfer through to the finals, and the other competitors in this race who are already sitting on the sidelines are actually going to have to go into the last chance qualifying. There's Faust going across the jump comfortably, followed by Timur Zanov and then Rhys Millen.
There's Tanner on the dirt. He's looking to be tidy here and not lose any time as he emerges onto the tarmac and back into that first straightaway. He's got a nice lead on Timur. Timur's going to try and reel him in. and they've raced against each other in Europe, and I wouldn't count him out just yet.
So Tanner Faust is working his way through this course. He wants that bonus point.